All right, it is our first title fight of the night, the first of two, as Stefan Ivanov is the challenger, and he is heading to the cage right now. Ivanov enters the cage with a record of 2 wins, 1 loss, 1 draw, as he will be taking on Devin Seitz, and you will hear the crowd get very loud when they introduce Seitz. As Seitz, the reigning title holder at 155 pounds as an amateur here for the Chosen Two. So Ivanov getting the once over. He is set to go. Now, let's take a look at the champion, Devin the Bulldog Seitz.
Next up, his opponent, Devin Seitz.
They love the Bulldog here at Monona Terrace. Devin Seitz, who won this championship in Chosen Few Fighting Championships number 16 over Bobby Oldenburg. That in a unanimous decision style is going to defend for the first time with a record of 2 wins, 2 losses. Seitz actually coming off a loss in LFA 70. We will talk about that. It was a split decision to Rodney Alexander. We'll bring that up as the fight moves along here. And what Seitz may or may not have learned from that loss. So Devin Seitz getting ready to head up to the cage. We will go up there right now to our cage announcer, Chris Garrity.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is brought to you by Alpha Tile and Stone and features 3 rounds for the Amateur Lightweight Championship. Introducing first, this man fighting out of the Rouse Performance Red Corner. He weighed in at 154.5 pounds. He hails from Schaumburg, Illinois. In 4 bouts, he has 2 victories representing the Midwest Training Center, the challenger, Stefan Ivanov. His opponent is this man, standing across the cage and fighting out of the Coliseum Bar, blue corner. He weighed in at 154.8 pounds. He represents the Chosen Few Gym and hails from right here in Madison, Wisconsin. In 4 amateur bouts, he has 2 victories, ladies. And gentlemen, he is the reigning, the defending, the undisputed amateur lightweight champion, the Pitbull, Devin Seitz.
I think I call him a bulldog. He's a pit bull. And there is a difference as Devin Seitz, the champion, is ready to go against Stefan Ivanov. Ivanov has the kind of name that you would expect from a 1980s heel in the WWF.
Yeah, that was a good right hand there from Seitz, but Ivanov does not seem to care at all. And that,
and
he
that
should, because he got cracked.
A good right hand, and Seitz puts Ivanov on his back, but Ivanov jumped up quickly and started grappling then with Seitz. As, wow, good action here to start this fight off.
Yeah, Ivanov thought he was, Seitz was a little soft, and then he got chin checked and figured out he's in a real fist fight. He went for that clinch right away, doing a good job of control right here, get some knees in, but definitely opening sequence favoring the champ.
Well, and I love the confidence from a fighter when you can come out like that, except for the fact that you got to remember, Seitz is wearing the strap for a reason. Protect your chin.
Yeah, Seitz, by the way, is coming off of a loss. We saw at LFA 70, a split decision loss to Rodney Alexander. I asked Seitz on my TV program, you know, what did you learn from that? He said he didn't learn anything. He wouldn't do anything different. He thought he won the fight.
Man, Ivanov right there. His head does not move at all when he swings, and his head's pretty high up. So if I was Seitz, I'd bury my chin a little bit and let that right hand go, because he had success with it pretty good early.
That left inside kick from Ivanov is really nice, though. It did buckle Seitz.
Seitz now backing up as Ivanov is walking him down. The one thing Seitz said that maybe he would have done differently against Alexander was be a little bit more aggressive, that we would see more of his pit bull style here tonight. But so far, Ivanov been able to keep that at bay, except for that first flurry.
Right, so it's just being a little tentative right here. You might want to start pumping that jab and swinging. You know you can touch him and put him on his butt. They make him fear the boogeyman. Make him remember why he didn't want to come at you the first time.
You know, we've talked about this in a few previous fights. Am I imagining size differences in fighters now, or does it seem like Ivanov is just huge compared to Seitz?
He does, yeah. I mean, just the two standing there and sizing each other up in the cage, it looks like Ivanov has him by maybe 10 pounds and 2 inches.
Pretty impressive for someone with that build to make 55.
Yeah.
Ivanov continuing to stalk down Seitz. Seitz now trying to answer with a right hand, but some of the aggression, at least the early aggression of Seitz, taken out of him by Ivanov.
Yeah, he's looking for that big right hand again. He knew he hit it once, so he's just throwing the right. You got to set that up, jab with. Now we get some leg kicks. That's not a bad idea. I'd say maybe add that jab in there a little bit, get Ivanov to lean, and then you can come and scoop that right hand. But Ivanov just using his size, being physical, pushing him back, stalking him.
That leg kick is going to pay dividends as the fight goes on, as long as he keeps it up, because Ivanov is putting a lot of weight on that front leg. Every time he stalks in, he's putting everything he has on that front leg. You keep chomping away at it, you take away half of his fight.
Final seconds tick away here in round number one. A good one for both fighters. We're back with round number two of this title fight right after this on TVW. Here's action from round number one as we check out the first few seconds of the first round, and that's when Devin Seitz was able to land a big right hand that dropped Ivanov.
Madison, Wisconsin, make some noise right now for our cage girl!
As much as it dropped the challenger, Ivanov was quick to get back up to his feet as Seitz now getting instruction from Alex Gilpin and also Kane Rizzo in the corner. And hopefully he is taking it here.
First thing Alex Gilpin did is walk up, lift his right leg up, and set it down right in front of him. In that same way that he's putting all that weight on the leg, I know they're telling him to continue with those kicks. That's huge important, especially when you see the mark that's already starting on the right leg of Ivanov. It's a target now.
You can see it on the back leg of Ivanov. There is a red welt that started up about midway through that first round. And so if you are Seitz, maybe that is the direction to go, and hopefully that's what he is going to try to do as he goes
right
for it right
it.
There. Yep. Taking the instruction of his corner, and if you're going to take instruction from anybody, why not take it from Rizzo and Gilpin? That's a good right by Seitz.
So Ivanov keeps leaning back into his own left, which is going to help Seitz get his right hand. And another thing he can do to keep landing that leg kick, keep swinging up, throw a couple big bombs up top, make him lean back to open up that outside leg kick. Like, keep that open by threatening the head again, and then, you know, maybe you catch him again with one of them and put him down.
And the confidence of Seitz is gaining by the second here if you watch him. Now, I don't like how low he's holding his hands, because I still think Ivanov has some power in his, but I do like that right's landing. He just needs to keep setting it up, keep with that left kick. And like Gerald said, what's eventually going to open up is that left high kick, too.
He's going to pump that jab a little bit more while he's coming in instead of just banking on the right. If I'm in Ivanov's corner, I'm telling him, hey, you got to touch this guy with something and get a hold of him. You know, either shoot and get a hold of the legs or push him into the cage and start beating him up in the clinch in order to slow him down.
Going back to Chris's points, you could see the body language of Seitz getting better as the fight's going on. It was missing against Rodney Alexander, as he never really seemed to show that kind of confidence that he is mounting right here in the second round.
And Ivanov is moving forward, but he's not quite getting the angle he needs. And even though he threw a couple left hands, nothing really made a solid connection with Seitz, and Seitz is still returning off those punches. If anything, Ivanov is still the one moving away when an exchange happens, or at the very least, he's initiating it and Seitz answers back, which is going to help him off a lot. But right there, that was a good head kick set up by Ivanov.
He didn't finish the kick, though.
No.
He threw it halfway up and stopped it. If he'd have went followed through with that kick, it would have landed solid.
Right. Now Ivanov starting to connect a little bit more with the hands and the kicks, looking a little bit better going that inside leg.
That four straight strikes struck by Ivanov now as he is scoring here in the second round. Landed a right to the face of Seitz. Also got a kick in there as well, as we're inside of a minute now in what is becoming a very even round.
If I'm Ivanov, I'm measuring Seitz up right now. Every time Seitz loads up the right hand, he takes his left hand and swings his elbow out and just leaves the entire left side of his head open.
Right uppercut by Seitz. Now he throws another right that seemed to land as well. Ivanov going upstairs with a kick again. As Ivanov coming in, he pushed Seitz back.
Right, he landed a decent uppercut there, trying to follow it up with another left. Now Ivanov starting to land a little more, pick up some steam, but still keeps leaning away and just barely getting out of the way of those big bombs that Seitz is throwing.
Blood coming from the nose of Devin Seitz as well, as Ivanov connected one of those shots right to the top of the nose of Devin Seitz. Good action in round number two. We'll see if it continues into the third and final round. The 155-pound Emmy title on the line here at the Chosen Few on TVW. Taking a look at the final 30 seconds now of round number two, as Ivanov in the second half of the second round was starting to control the action and really starting to dictate to Devin Seitz.
Yeah, definitely picked it up there, landing that good uppercut, landed some leg kicks, really started pushing Seitz back, not just with cutting off the cage, but with actual strikes and forcing him to retreat.
You can see the welt on the back leg of that right leg of Ivanov is still there. Seitz was attacking that leg early on in the round, but kind of stopped halfway through the round.
I think that was a result of the Ivanov offense, but one thing that Seitz has been doing the first two rounds as well, he was throwing that right straight to the body. And we'll see, so far Ivanov still looks just as fresh.
Crowd getting into it here for the third and final round, trying to urge Seitz on. Seitz, a unanimous decision over Oldenburg to get the title and then lost a split decision. He is used to going the distance.
We've had a lot of fighters fight here in Madison that are associated with the Chosen Few gym. I don't know if I've ever heard a crowd scream like that in between a second and third round like the Pitbull crowd just screamed.
Yeah, he definitely has a lot of crowd support, always has ever since he started fighting here. The crowd solidly in his corner, but Ivanov has been mounting a good attack again. Blood coming from the nose of Devin Seitz as a couple of shots landed by Ivanov. Seitz retaliating with a good right. And
ooh,
another good
right,
right
hand. He stumbled him. He's
and
hurt.
Ivanov in trouble.
Oh, Seitz has got to separate and gain some space. He can't let Ivanov stay here and recover. Ivanov's got an underhook. It's going to be hard to get him off of him. Seitz got to dig his underhook. Yep, separate on the face, make some space. Ivanov doing the right thing.
Seitz has landed some monster shots in this fight, and Ivanov takes his stanky leg back, but then comes up and clinches. You have to be impressed with this kid's chin. No matter what happens in this fight, the fact that his chin is held up with some of the shots Seitz has thrown so far is absolutely outstanding.
Yeah, the right that Seitz landed in this round, the biggest since round number one, that flattened Ivanov. But Ivanov both times has been able to answer, once by popping up quickly and once by able to tie up Seitz as he's getting the cobwebs cleared out of his head right now against Devin Seitz as we're halfway through this third and final round.
Seitz's face has been touched up a little bit. I just saw him peek up at the clock. He wants his fight over. If I'm Ivanov, I start really hunting and throwing some volume at him right now.
Right, and right there he came in with a big, but Seitz always returning.
Yeah, good left by Ivanov, answered by a right of Devin Seitz. Both fighters going at it here in this third round. This has been a great fight.
Seitz has been masterful at that retreating right hand, that defensive right hand. It has landed over and over again. And it's just, as hard as Ivanov is throwing shots, it's amazing Seitz can get that off and land it the way he has.
Slipped.
He slipped and it's
big
awesome.
Punches.
good connections there by Sykes after the slip by Ivanov. Sykes taking advantage right now.
Yeah, this actually works out completely in Sykes' favor. Sykes has excellent top control, excellent wrestling. I think he won the first two rounds pretty easily. He can cruise right now.
Right, Sykes, I'd say hang out right here, land some blows, make sure it doesn't get stood up, you're good. Ivanov's got to work. He's got to either get a submission, use those butterfly hooks, put his feet in his hips, push away and get up.
The pit bull now landing a couple of shots in, left and right. Ivanov just holding on for dear life here. It is the final 10 seconds of the third and final round. Sykes looking to defend that belt. I think the crowd thinks that he has done enough to do so. Ivanov will finish the fight on his back. Devin Sykes getting a loud ovation here from the crowd in this title fight. We'll see if he did enough to retain the title right after this on TVW. For a third straight fight, Devin Sykes has to wait to go to the scorecards and the judges' decisions as a fighter. No matter what, I gotta think, even if you think you won all three rounds, you just get nervous going down to the judges. And that's what Devin Sykes is waiting for right now, as we are as well. Stefan Ivanov looking for his first title in an amateur career that has spanned 8 years. That's right, he started fighting way back in 2011. Only four fights over that time. So a big decision
ladies
coming up here.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we go.
Before we get to an official decision, come on, one more round of applause for a great title fight. After three rounds of lightweight championship action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Both Judge Winter and Sebeda scores the bout 29-28, while Judge Wickers has it 30-27, all in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, and still lightweight champion, the Pitbull, Devin Sykes.
Great action here in the title fight. Devin Sykes retains the strap to the crowd's delight as he improves to 3-2 with the victory over Stefan Ivanov. That was a good one. That's it for our amateur fights. The pro fights are coming up next, including our main event, Patrick Delgado against Craig Eckelberg for the 165-pound title. Don't go
Devin,
anywhere. And before we do that, hey,
fantastic
don't go anywhere
job.
As you listen to this
you
interview.
You retained your belt with an impressive three-round victory over a very tough, very big opponent. Tell me a little bit about your quick thoughts right after the fight. How'd you feel about that decision?
After the fight, I can't say I didn't know I was going to win. That guy's tough, man. He hits like a truck. Holy cow. I look at my face. I can see. I don't even have to look at my face. Well, there it is right there. Wow.
You landed a lot of great defensive retreating rights, and he seemed to take him and come right back at you, but you definitely caused most of the damage, landed most of the significant strikes in that, but he definitely was big and strong in that fight. What do you see happening next?
Well, this is actually my last amateur fight. I'm going pro. First of all, I want to thank everyone who came out tonight. I have so many supporters every time I fight. They follow me everywhere. I want to thank all my sponsors. I got plenty of them that make everything possible. All my trainings are free, everything. I do have one last thing I want to say. For my first professional fight, Rodney, brother, I love you, but we need to run it back, homie. Also, if you don't want to take the fight, which I know you will, you're a very respectable opponent, I want Felipe Martinez. And he's the guy that beat you last. So let's get it, baby. I love you, Rodney. Thank you.
Rodney Alexander, Felipe Martinez just got called out by your champion, Devin Sykes. Come on, one more round of applause. Let's go.
I saw Rodney Alexander here tonight. I'm sure he would take that fight. Devin Sykes, your winner. Pro fight coming up next as you are watching the Chosen Few Fighting Championship number 17, and you are watching TVW.